If you build websites or landing pages for clients, you know that getting feedback from them can be extremely difficult. They want what changed where to what color, and the text should be how much bigger where. It's very, very difficult to understand what the average person is saying about a website. So that's why I'm excited to check out Simple Commenter. This is a solution that you've probably seen other things similar to this in the past, where you install a script on a website, and then we can click around and leave feedback right on the page. The thing that really interests me about Simple Commenter is it's only $49. It's a lifetime deal, and there are no upgrades. There is one plan, $49. Here it is. It's called the Unlimited Plan. It gets us unlimited tokens, unlimited domains, there's email notifications, and it is a hosted solution. We don't need to self-host it. It's going to be on their backend. And of course, it also works with any CMS or framework, so you don't need anything particular here in order to use the tool. But is it any good? Let's find out. So here is the backend for Simple Commenter. Overall, I think it's a nice, clean, simple interface. It seems pretty impressive so far, but we haven't really done very much. So let's add in a new domain right here. I'm going to use my WordPress demo site called serversavant.com. I'll click add domain. And the first thing I need to do is add this snippet of code to the head tag of my website. So I'm going to copy it right here. Now I'm going to be installing this code on a WordPress website. And if you go and look, there is no Simple Commenter plugin available on the WordPress repository. So what do you do? Well, you just simply need to inject this anywhere you'd put your header and footer scripts for things like Google Analytics or the Facebook Meta Pixel. So what I'm going to do is use a tool called Fluent Snippets. It's totally free on the WordPress repository. If you're using WordPress, this is what Fluent Snippets looks like when you search for the plugin. And then in the left-hand sidebar, you're going to click on Fluent Snippets, add a new snippet, and I'm going to choose Content Snippet right here and then paste in my script. All right, I went ahead and gave my snippet a name, and I set it to display site-wide header. And the next thing I did is a little bit more advanced, but it might be useful to some of you out there. I set up some conditional logic. Basically, what I'm doing here is only showing this code or only running this code if the user is logged in and they are an administrator. That means anybody else who logs in, like a customer or just a random person who visits the website and isn't even logged in, won't see the feedback form because I only want to get feedback from the right people. All right, I'm going to activate this snippet and now I'm visiting the site. And right down here, I've got the Simple Commenter snippet. If I click on this icon right here, I can click anywhere on the page to leave a comment. So let's say I wanted to update the text right here. I can leave my comment and then hit post, but there's some other features as well. So right over here, I can click on this icon to let everybody know who's leaving the comment. All right, so here is my info. I'm going to confirm and comment. Now, before I actually click post to post my comment, there are two other options I want to show you. The first one over here is for markup. If I click on this little pencil icon, I can actually draw on the screen. So I could maybe draw a box right here, point at something over here, or just literally sketch out whatever I have in mind with the pencil tool. By the way, you can easily click and move these around if you end up placing them in the wrong spot. There's also undo and redo buttons right over here. So if you decide, oh, I really didn't want that drawing, no worries, you don't have to refresh the page. Okay, so that's markup. The other feature that is available when leaving a comment is to take a screenshot. So just click this button right here and allow it to share the window, hit share this window, and now a screenshot has actually been attached to my comment. That way, the person who's receiving the comment can see what it is that you see, because not all browsers render websites exactly the same. So this can be really helpful to get feedback. I can view the screenshot right here so I can see exactly what I'm going to be submitting with my comment. All right, this is looking pretty good. So I'm going to go ahead and hit post. And now I can see there is one comment on this page. If I click on it, I can see a list of all of the comments. I can see what OS I was using, what the screen resolution was when the comment was posted. And then I can click resolve if the comment has been taken care of, or I can click right here to actually go to the comment, maybe leave a reply, and then eventually mark it as resolved. Okay, so we have now seen this mode right over here, which lets us actually leave comments. And then this mode right here, which lets us view the comments. Of course, the last one is to view the page without any markup at all. So if you click this, it will all be hidden. Now, I have found what I consider to be maybe a bug. I'm not entirely certain, but when I hide the comments, I would expect to not see those comments again at all. I should be able to view the website in its entirety. But if I move my mouse, they reappear. It's not really the end of the world, but I don't think it's the intended functionality. Now back over on the simple commenter website, I'm in the domains tab, which will be a list of all of the websites I'm using this tool on. If I click into a website, I'm going to be able to see all of my active conversations right here, which is really nice. So you can log into one central repository and respond to all of your customers. Now there are a few other options for configuration that are both important and extremely helpful. On the theme section, I can choose the colors for the widget that appears. This can be really important, especially if the colors clash with the existing website, making it hard to utilize or even read the text that's on the screen. So we can set up the active and overlay colors, and they give us a preview down here. So if I went with more of a gray active color, the buttons would look like this as I click through them. And reloading my site, it does show up right away over here. This color right here, the overlay color, that's the color that shows up when you actually go to leave a comment itself. So you can make sure that that stands out. It doesn't, you know, interfere with the text that's on the screen. The other two theme configuration options we have are for the alignment for the little widget. So by default, it's on the right. I can make it go over to the left by toggling this switch. And then we can also have a compact modal, which will just basically make this widget a little bit smaller. I'll go ahead and save these and show you what they look like. So this should jump to the other side of the screen and get smaller here as I reload the page. Here we go. And there it is, not too much smaller, honestly, but it's definitely on the left-hand side of the page. Yeah, what do you guys think? Is this actually getting any smaller? Here it is in the compact mode, turning that off, reloading. It looks exactly the same to me. The next option over is for setup and access. The first one here is active. Is the widget on? We can toggle it on and off. If you're not currently accepting submissions, just go ahead and turn it off. That way you can leave the code on the website, but it still won't display. Now, earlier on in this video, I talked about using some conditional logic inside of Fluent snippets to basically hide the modal from users who I don't want to access the tool. Well, you can do the same thing even if you're not using WordPress or Fluent snippets right here inside of the setup and access screen. Under access configuration, I've got a bunch of different options here. Maybe the easiest one to understand is down at the bottom, allow client login. So we simply toggle this on right here. And then we add our clients right over here, hit save, and then your client can log in as a client by simply entering in their domain and logging in with a magic email link, so no passwords required. Then after you log in, it'll look just like this, very similar to what the administrator account looks like, except now I can't add new sites. I can simply go visit the website and I'll be able to see the code over there. There's a visit domain button, just click it and you should get access, assuming you didn't do the fancy conditional logic stuff I talked about before. So if you want to use this feature, go ahead and turn that off. Then your client can simply log in, click visit domain, and they'll see the widget down in the corner. So that is the client login system. It works pretty well, but there is the downside that the tier that we get from AppSumo only allows 5 clients per project. So remember, you can have unlimited projects, but each project is limited to 5 clients plus your user account, right? So 6 total. Well, actually, we get 5 members on our user account, so 10 total. Another way to delegate access is to use what's called a query string, which is basically a fancy word that just means a little bit of text at the end of your website's URL. So you toggle this on and watch the code over here as I do this. Remember, this is the code that we pasted onto our website. If I toggle this on, it actually changes that code a little bit. So make sure you update the code inside of the head of your website in order for this feature to work properly. But then the widget is only going to show up if you add this little bit of text at the end of your URL. It's not going to change anything else on your website. It simply just gets the widget to show up so that people can leave comments. All right, so I've turned this on. I'm going to go ahead and save my domain settings. I'll update my code and I'll show you how this works. All right, updating my snippet here. That's good to go. And just to verify, here is the website in a private window. I don't see the widget at all. If I go up to the URL and I add in that query string, hit return, I should now see the widget. There it is. So everything's working as expected. I think that's a great solution because you could just send that URL and just let your clients know that that's the special commenting URL. If they want to add that at the end of any page, they can send you a message directly from the website. But if you want to have a little bit more security, they do have token-based access, which basically means if I turn this on, now users can only comment if they have what's called a valid token. So I've got that setting turned on now. Watch what happens when I reload. Now, I still see something in the corner, but it's not the full-blown widget. Instead, if I click right here, it says log into Simple Commenter, and basically I need to enter in my email address to get a login link. Now, you might be thinking, well, I don't really want this to show up for everybody. So what you can do is combine this with the query string that we looked at in the previous example, and then people can visit the website with the query string and then log in with the token. That'll keep things more secure. Otherwise, just a few other options to note on this page. We can turn on and off email notifications. This is going to allow you to get notifications when someone leaves a comment on your page. You can set a frequency limit here, which is great because sometimes clients will go through and leave 1,000 comments in one go and you'll end up having 1,000 different emails. So you can set it to be hourly, daily, weekly, or even monthly. And then there are toggle switches to turn on and off those markup features. They call them drawing here and screenshots. So if you don't want your customers or your clients to be leaving screenshots or markup, just go ahead and toggle those off. Then the last feature over here is localization, which basically lets you translate the words inside of the plugin. So if you don't want to call it a post, you wanted to call it an article, you could easily do that. Just go ahead and update this, hit save, and then the language on the plugin itself or on the modal pop-up is going to change from post into article. This would be great if you want to translate the tool into another language, and it's very easy to copy and paste the localizations from one domain to another. You just select right up here and you can basically import those localizations so that you don't have to do the same things over and over again if you're serving clients with a particular language. Overall, I find Simple Commenter to be a delightfully simple implementation of this type of tool. I highly recommend you give it a try if you think it might be useful in your business. I'm going to go ahead and give this one a score of 8.5 out of 10, a really high score for a great value. Now, a few things you should know about this deal is, well, one, I've got an AppSumo link in my description. If you click on that before making it a purchase, it does support this channel and this content so I can make more daily LTD reviews like this one. The other thing you should know is this is not an AppSumo Select deal, which does mean there is slightly more risk, although at $49, I feel pretty comfortable and we still get a 60-day return policy. That's all for today. What tools should I review next? Leave me a comment down below and let me know. My name is Dave. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next review.